In this short video, I would like to demonstrate what alkalinity is. So remember, a measurement of alkalinity in water can tell you how much acid or base can be absorbed without changing the pH of the water. For this demonstration, I prepared two beakers with a water sample. Beaker number one contains only deionized water, and sample number two contains deionized water, and I dissolved a little bit of baking soda to it. This is just baking soda, which you might know. And baking soda, chemically speaking, is sodium bicarbonate. So I dissolved a little bit of it, so we have some bicarbonate in the water that contributes to the alkalinity of the water sample. So what we're going to do now is I will add, drop by drop, a few milliliters of regular vinegar to the water sample now. Vinegar is a little bit acidic, has a pH of approximately 3. And we will look what the pH of the water sample is doing while I'm adding it. So I have here our pH meter, HQD, and you see the deionized water sample has a pH of approximately 5.5. So now I'm gonna drop a little bit of the vinegar to the water sample and let's see what the pH or how the pH is behaving. So I put one drop only, takes a few seconds, and you see already, you have already a drop of a pH of 1 to 4.4 with only one drop of vinegar. So it reacts very quickly to the acid. I add another one. Second drop, and the pH will further decrease to a pH of 4 already. Yeah, so we started at 5.6 approximately, and we are already at 4 with 2 drops of vinegar. I can add a third one, and the pH will drop a little further, but remember the vinegar itself has a pH of approximately 3. So with 3 drops, we were able to decrease the pH from 5.6 to 3.9. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I will rinse the pH electrode. Dry it a little bit with a soft cloth. And then I will put the other sample, put the pH meter in. Let's see how the pH is stabilizing. That takes a few seconds. So that is now deionized water with the sodium bicarbonate. We let it stabilize for a few seconds. So you see, we are approximately at 7.4 or 7.3. Yeah, 7.2. And now it's very close to showing a stable value. So we're approximately at 7.1. And I proceed the same way that I did with the previous sample and add some drops of vinegar. Remember, I just added 3 drops of vinegar to the previous sample and the pH dropped significantly. So we're at 7.06 now, and I will put a drop of vinegar to it, 1 drop. It reacts a little bit, but not that much. So we are still at 7. I put a second drop. No, I put already 3 drops to it. And you see the pH decreases a bit, but not too much. Add some new drops. Add another 2 drops. So it decreases very, very slowly. Another two drops. And you see there's almost no change in pH. That means there is something in the water which absorbs the acidity from the vinegar so that the pH cannot drop. So that is why alkalinity is also referred to the buffer capacity of water, because now the vinegar, or let's say the alkalinity buffers the water so that the pH is not changing very much by adding an acid. Last time I add some drops, 1, 2, 3 drops. And you see the pH is not changing very much. That was a short demonstration what alkalinity is.